Okay, today we are going to show how to service the one engine, one Mercedes-Benz engine. It's called M110. It has been used in a couple of cars, like for example this 70 years SL Roadster, but it also has been used in a couple of the smaller S-Class Mercedes, and also in the middle-class Mercedes, and in the coupe of the 70s and the 80s. So actually the M110 engine has been built into quite a lot of cars, and it is known to be very robust. It can make up to 400 or sometimes even 600,000 kilometer, but it needs some maintenance, of course good oil. And one of the maintenance which can be done relatively simple by the user himself is adjusting the valve play. So today we are going to see how we can adjust the valve play ourselves, so you don't need to go to the garage for that and spend a lot of money. Ah yeah, okay, let's have a quick look at this overview. So that roughly explains what we're going to do. So this is actually, this is the valve. It closes this combustion chamber, and over here the fresh air and the gasoline is coming in. Over here the exhaust gas is going out, so this is the outlet or exhaust valve. And these valves are connected by this bar. And once the engine has been running for quite some time, then this bar is usually getting a little bit longer. And then the valve play has to be adjusted. We are going to do this with a special screw. You will see it later. And fortunately, we don't have to measure the entire length from here to there, but we only need to measure the valve play in this little gap over here. And the workshop manual says that the cold engine requires an intake valve play of 0.1 millimeter, and the warm engine, which means below 60 degrees Celsius, requires a valve play of 0.15 millimeter. On the outtake, it's a little bit, on the outlet, it's a little bit different. Over here, the cold engine requires a larger valve play of 0.2 millimeter over here, and of 0.3 millimeter if you are doing this with a warm engine. But I think it's rather recommended to do it with a cold engine.
So first of all, we are going to explain which tools are necessary for adjusting the valve play, and then we will need this. In any case, we will need this 13 millimeter wrench socket. It goes together with one of those handles. It will be used to open the case of the engine. And then we will need one of those 27 millimeter wrench socket. We will use this in order to turn the engine a little bit, because once the case is open, then we cannot really start the engine anymore, so we should do that manually by means of this 27 millimeter wrench socket, which goes together with another handle, of course. And then what will be required also for sure is this 17 millimeter wrench. We will use it in order to adjust the valve play itself. And then something which is also very important is this so-called feeler gauge. I think that is how it is called, and it basically consists of those thin metal, how do you call that? Thin metal, yeah, whatever, thin metal plates, films, I don't know. And over here you can see each of them has a number written on it. So for example, this is 0.25. That means that it is a quarter of a millimeter thick, and we will basically use this feeler gauge to measure the valve play. So we will simply stick it into that little space between the, you will see it later, and then you will see whether the play is too large or it's too small. So that's a fairly simple device. It only costs €6, and you will need that in any case. Okay, now we are going to prepare to open the case of the engine, and this requires first of all to remove those cables which go to the ignition plugs. And something which is very important is that you remember which cable goes into which plug. So they are numbered this way. This is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And actually for the 6th one, we will not remove that, so it only requires us to remove the first 5 ones. And then I would suggest that you simply write small numbers on those cables just in order not to confuse them, because if the wrong ignition plug is fired at the wrong time, your engine will never work properly again. So simply write small numbers on the cables, as I did over here, and then you will know where they go later. So we'll try to... Ah, yeah, and there's another thing. You should not put any tools into the engine, especially not into the inner part of the engine and not into this part of the car, because later you might forget it and then you might screw your engine. So simply put it somewhere else if you don't need it. Okay, so let's try to unplug them now. I will loosen this first. Number 4, number 5, number 6. So in order you get confused, I will show it to you as well, which one goes where. So this is number 1. Number 1 actually goes in goes in over here. And then we will loosen number 2. This goes in over here. So next we have to unscrew those. I think it's 14 screws. That's fairly simple. I would recommend that you do not open one immediately, but you simply loosen them a little bit first. Because keep in mind, we are dealing with an aluminium engine and actually the cover is not very hard, so it might break easily. We have to handle it with great care. Also, don't forget to unplug this intake, or I think it's rather an outlet for the air. Some remainder air which comes in over here, it goes back into this air system. But actually opening the top of this engine is not very complicated. So we're almost finished now. We only need to remove those 3 inner screws. They are actually a little bit longer. Then you could actually replace all the rubber rings, because sometimes they are old, and if you reinstall the case or the top later, then the oil might be leaking. So I'm going to show you a few rubber rings in a minute. There is a set of rubber rings sold by Mercedes. It's not very expensive, and you could take the chance to change all the rubber in this context. Actually, I think it's not really rubber, and you will also get a replacement for these copper rings. Okay, now let's remove it. Here you see the open the engine from the top. So over here on the, from our perspective, from the right hand side, these are the intake valve. The air is coming in over here, and these are the exhaust valves. And these are, for example, the 3 rubber rings, or actually, it's 5. And then you could also, in that replacement kit, you also get the seal for which goes all along the border of this case. Okay.